Enough for everybody, because the world can contain much, much, much more. And with technology and the confluence of these three things that I just mentioned, there is enough for everybody. So we want to take this innovation, this technology, just to spread it. And we do it with our friends, with our precious, precious friends. So that's what I'm here for. So let's talk about the relationships between India and Israel. Satellite to monitor the fields and to calculate the exact amount of water and fertilizers that each part of the field needs and give it the exact amount with drip irrigation and fertilizing. So farmers in Israel, some of them, yes, are engineers and scientists, because in Israel agriculture is high-tech, high technology. So still we did a lot with agriculture. We have 29, just we're going to inaugurate two more centers of excellence in agriculture here in India. Centers that Israeli experts bring all the know-how in agriculture and share it here in India with our friends, with the farmers here in India. One more thing about agriculture, the next excellence will be about in. Someone said, why not try something else, because fish like salty water. So they just fill pools with those waters and start so well, it's so successful. So now my parents, for example, they came to Israel at 13 years old, and they really believed as an ideal that the main pillar to build the new. So both of my brothers are teachers. That's when I retired from the army, shows how much the economy was, yes? What is the worth of the Israeli economy? So if we start just to see from the 80s, early 80s, until now, you see the remarkable progress, the remarkable growth of the Israeli economy. In the early stages, Israeli grew in the rate of 13% per year, and the average last year is in 5%, and still growing. Now Israel is considered the 8th economy in the world, and GDP per capita in Israel, you can see, is now about $40,000 per capita. So it's one of the most developed countries in the economy. Is the memorial of the Holocaust. I don't know if you all of you know about what is the Holocaust. The disaster that happened about 100 years ago to our people, to the Jewish people, when 6 million Jews were murdered. Special day of memorial, so it even makes it more special for me to be here. What I'd like to do in the next, so if something works so well, we want to have more of it. Can also tell you, for us, Israel, India is a strong economy that grows so well. It's so important because we think that India has a very, very important role. It's how you heard my background, because you understand that I'm not originally from the Foreign Service. I'm not a career diplomat, but still.
Even in an era where thinking outside of the box has become the new box, and words and ideas are transforming the world. But even in this fascinating, non-stop, ever-changing world, there's a unique place where people live by the phrase, necessity is the mother of invention.
So, short video. Well, is